Welcome again. Here we have another problem. Emily lost two blue buttons from his shirt. A bag of spare buttons contains 6 white buttons and 2 blue buttons. Emily takes 3 buttons from the bag at random without replacement. Calculate the probability that all 3 buttons are white. Now, the easiest way is to use a two-double. If we have got white buttons and blue buttons, that means on our first picking, we could pick a white button or a blue button. Now, since the white buttons are 6 and the total buttons will be 8, so the probability for picking the white button will be 6/8, and the probability for picking the blue button will be 2/8. In the second picking, having picked the white button first, there is a possibility we can pick a white button again or a blue button. Now, since we picked the white first, now the number of white buttons have reduced to 5. And one button being picked, the total is now 7. However, the blue button were not touched. Since they were not touched, they are still 2 as they were. But since one button was picked, now the total is 7. Having picked blue first, it's possible to pick white or blue again. Now, if you pick blue first, the number of blue buttons are now 1/7. While the white one was not touched, so there are still 6/7. Picking the third button. Picking white, we can pick white again or we can pick blue. Now, since white were 5, now there will be 4/6. Remember, the first was white, the second was white, meaning blue was not touched at all, there are still 2 intact. Having picked previously blue, we can pick white or blue again. But the first time we picked white, the second time we picked blue, meaning a white button has reduced by 1 and a blue button has reduced by 1. So, now we shall have only 5 out of the total 6, and the blue are 2, now will be only 1 out of 6. In the same case, here, we picked blue and white, so we shall have the same probability. On the last part, we picked blue first, we picked blue second, meaning we didn't pick white at all, so there's still 6 out of the total 6. We picked the blue, and we are told the only 2 blue buttons, meaning they're completely over, so we don't have any chance of picking blue. Now, what are the possible outcomes of picking? We can pick white, 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 right? That is our outcome. Or we could pick white, white, and blue. White, blue, white. White, blue, blue. Blue, white, white. Blue, white, blue. Blue, blue, white. And finally, blue, blue, blue. Now, in box A, they are asking us to find all 3 buttons being white. That means we shall go with that option. What are the probabilities for this option? That is 6/8 and 5/7 and 4/6. Giving us 120/336. We can simplify this to 5/14. On the second part, we are asked exactly one of the three patterns is good. Now, let's go back to our key diagram. If you look at this part here, we have exactly one is blue. If you look at this next option here, we have exactly one is blue. And that one, we have exactly one blue. All the other, we will not have one blue. We have either two blue or none. Therefore, our personal outcomes here, having only one blue, could be white, white and blue, or white, blue, white, or blue, white, white. Now, look at the probabilities for this. White and white and blue. Or white and blue. This all we shall end up with 180 over 336, of which we can simplify to 15 over 28. That is the solution to our problem. If you enjoyed the discussion, you can subscribe to my channel. My name is Ishengoma.